Let's look at another redox reaction, this time the decomposition of potassium chlorate. It's a decomposition reaction, so it must be redox. Potassium chlorate, KClO3, decomposes to form oxygen gas and potassium chloride. So we can balance this by putting a 2 in front of the KClO3 and give us 3 oxygen molecules and 2 formula units of potassium chloride. Let's figure out what's oxidizing and what's reducing here. So let's figure out our oxidation states. The potassium starts with a +1 charge. It's an alkali metal. And the chlorate, as a polyatomic ion, has a -1 charge. Potassium is ending with a +1 charge because it's bonded to the negative charged chloride. So potassium here is a spectator. It's neither oxidizing nor reducing. The chlorine is starting with a +5 charge. You have a +1 from the potassium and 3 -2s from the oxygen. So the chlorine has to have a +5 charge. As I said a moment ago, the chloride in the product has a -1 charge. So the chlorine is going from a +5 to a -1, that's reduction. Our oxygen is starting out with a -2 charge, that's in the chlorate ion, and it's turning into elemental oxygen, which has a neutral charge. Well, that's an increase in charge. So the oxygen is oxidizing. Now, if we used our initial definition of oxidation, this wouldn't make sense. We're not adding oxygen to oxygen. But if we used the correct definition and show an increase in oxidation state, we can see that the oxygen here is oxidizing. Now we can look further into what's happening by creating what are called half reactions. The half reactions actually show the oxidation and reduction process. They track what's gaining electrons and what's losing electrons. Remember, we said that redox is driven by a transfer of electrons. In our balanced reaction, we said that the oxidation was oxygen, going from a -2 to a neutral charge. And we said the reduction was the chlorine, going from a +5 to a -1 charge. Well, let's talk about the electrons here. How do you go from a -2 charge to a neutral charge? In order to oxidize, in order to increase your oxidation state, you have to lose electrons. So to go from -2 to neutral, you have to lose or give off 2 electrons. Reduction is the lowering of your oxidation state, or you have to gain electrons. To go from a +5 to a -1, you have to gain 6 electrons. And so here you see in these half reactions, the oxidation is the losing of electrons. Electrons are being given off as a product. Reduction is the gaining of electrons. Electrons are being added as a reactant. But these half reactions are not balanced. In our balanced equation, I don't have 1 oxygen. I actually have 6 oxygens. KClO3 has 3 oxygens, and there are 2 of them. And then we have 3 O2s at the end. So if I have 6 oxygens, that means each oxygen is giving off 2 electrons, and so I'm losing a total of 12 electrons. In my reduction, I don't have 1 chlorine, I actually have 2 chlorines. So if I have 2 chlorines, each gaining 6 electrons, that means 12 electrons are being gained. And that's not a coincidence. If your reaction is balanced, all of the electrons that are being lost in oxidation must be gained in reduction. We are transferring all of the electrons. And so that's what it means to have a balanced redox reaction. Not only are your atoms balanced, not only is the charge the same on one side of the reaction as the other, but all of your electrons will be balanced in the half reactions.